President Marcos lauds the public-private partnership concession agreement for the Laguindingan International Airport, which aims to modernize and rehabilitate Mindanao's second busiest airport. Marcos witnessed the signing of the contract between the Transportation Department, the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines, and private concessionaire Aboitiz Infracapital. Now, under the deal, Aboitiz will manage the operations and maintenance of the airport for 30 years. The project is expected to increase the airport's capacity from 1.6 million passengers every year to nearly double, 3.9 million in the first phase and 6.3 million by the end of phase two.
The improvement of the airport will significantly boost tourism, create jobs, increase business presence, and ultimately aid in our goal, in achieving our goal of economic growth. We look forward to witnessing a revitalized Laguindingan International Airport, a reliable hub that will inspire everyone to explore what lies beyond its terminal gates.
The signing follows the recent turnover of the Nino Aquino International Airport to NAIA Infracorp, led by San Miguel Corporation. The Philippines targeting to improve its ranking in the World Bank's so-called Be Ready Report. Now, this study assesses countries' business and investment climates. The 2024 Be Ready Report released earlier this month ranked the Philippines 16th out of 50 economies with a score of 70.68 out of 100 in terms of its regulatory framework. This puts the country in the top 40% of those surveyed. The composition of economies included in the study subject to change, with the Philippines not expected to be included in the 2025 edition, but set to return in 2026. By then, the Anti-Red Tape Authority aims to improve the country's ranking, targeting inclusion in the top 20%.
We are going to form technical working groups to address involving the 10 sectors, priority sectors. Number one, yung starting a business, with starting and closing a business, sa labor, sa and so many others. No? And these technical working groups that we will be creating will be forming together with the agencies involved, so that not only in terms of having a good ranking, but really driving our economy forward. Kung lahat ng mga programa, initiatives na ginagawa po under the directive of the President, if all those initiatives, yung mga government processes and services will be streamlined and digitalized under a one-stop shop. Kasi po, ang survey iba ngayon eh. Dati, sa Quezon City lang nakafocus yung annual doing business survey. Ngayon po, across the country, and they will be conducting the survey from among the, not only from the yung mga private sector, no, but even from the professionals itself. So ang hirap po ito, talagang very technical, kaya po ang ARTA ay nakatutok dito.
The private operator of Manila's International Airport vows smooth travel for passengers during the Ondas exodus. The new NAIA Infrastructure Corporation says additional manpower from government agencies will help manage the expected increase in passenger traffic at the airport. It is also working with airlines for early check-in counter openings and with transport service providers to increase vehicle availability at the NAIA. The NNIC adds it will free up parking spaces at Terminal 3 to accommodate more vehicles. Local governments in the metro also bracing for the upcoming Ondas break. Now, in Manila, up to 800,000 visitors are expected at Manila South Cemetery, while 1.5 million are seen flocking to Manila North Cemetery. Pets are not allowed inside the two cemeteries, which will operate from 5 a.m. to 7 p.m. only. In contrast, San Juan Cemetery will allow pets and will be open from 6 a.m. to 12 midnight. Only 18 vendors with special permits from the LGU are allowed to operate outside the cemetery. Firearms, bladed weapons, liquor, and playing cards are strictly prohibited and will be confiscated at the entrance gate. Now, to ensure police visibility, San Juan City Police has deployed bike patrollers inside and outside the cemetery. About 18,000 police personnel set to be deployed to secure transportation hubs, thoroughfares, and cemeteries for UNDAS. The PNP says it has authorized regional directors to adjust their alert levels as needed to maintain security in their areas. Additionally, different augmentations will be implemented in typhoon-hit areas where reserve forces will be mobilized to assist police personnel. Local government units have been advised to submit traffic plans, including schedules for major road closures in advance to prevent traffic congestion. More than 1,000 personnel from the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority, or MMDA, will also be deployed to manage the increased flow of departing passengers. Mani Pangilinan's power provider Meralco bullish its robust growth in the first 9 months of the year will lead to better than expected full year results. We have more from Lady Vicencio.
The Manila Electric Company expects its profit to exceed its 43 billion peso target this year, thanks to the strong performance of its units. For the first 9 months of 2024, Meralco's consolidated core net income rose by 17% to 35.1 billion pesos from 30 billion pesos in the same period last year.
Growth drivers for this year's significant growth in core net income are across the board, no? Distribution, the distribution business has been report record results for this year. For the generation, despite the slow start in the first quarter this year, they have managed to recover such that the full year consolidated core net income of the generation group will be slightly ahead of last year's core net income, and despite the lower profit results from Singapore.
Meralco's residential sales rose due to more power consumption amid warmer temperatures. Commercial sales also rose due to a surge in office occupancy and consumption by hotels. The power distributor spent 28 billion pesos on its operational expenses for the maintenance of its distribution utilities and higher cost of software maintenance. Pangilinan, meanwhile, expects the peso's depreciation against the U.S. dollar to have an impact on electricity rates.
The depreciation of the exchange rate is going to impact on fuel prices. No? There's certainly imported inputs to the thermal plants, both coal and gas, no? Because we import quite a bit of our coal and gas. So that could have an impact on power rates. So that could counterbalance the beneficial effect of easing inflation.
Pangilinan also expresses more interest in building a new nuclear power plant than reviving the Bataan nuclear power plant. South Korea recently inked a deal with the Philippine government to start a feasibility study on the rehabilitation of the non-operational nuclear power plant. Pangilinan says they will wait for the outcome of the feasibility study. The Meralco Group has been in talks with South Korean firms as it looks to establish nuclear power facilities in the country.
If they allow us to explore building a new plant, we'll do it. No? We'd like to take a very serious look at that, di ba? Because if you want energy independence, this is it. Di ba?
Lady Vicencio, ABS-CBN News.
An update on the weather now. Residents in the northern and northeastern sections of Luzon can expect a rainy Halloween and All Saints Day as severe tropical storm Leon slightly intensifies and approaches typhoon status. The storm was last spotted east of Tuguegalau City in Cagayan, packing winds of up to 110 kilometers per hour and gusts reaching 135 kph. It's forecast to rapidly intensify in the next 12 hours and could reach super typhoon status. Leon is expected to exit the Philippine area of responsibility by Thursday evening or early Friday and make landfall along the eastern coast of Taiwan. Several areas in Luzon and Visayas have also been placed under Tropical Cyclone Wind Signal Number 1.